This is part one of a series on AdaBoost algorithm called Adaptive Boosting, which is the 9th module of machine learning. Let's take a look at the full table of contents of AdaBoost. Chapter 1 and Chapter 2 provide an overview of AdaBoost. In Chapter 3, we will look at the AdaBoost algorithm for binary classification. Chapter 4 deals with the multi-class classification problem. The SAMI algorithm is used for multi-class classification. And in Chapter 6, we're going to look at AdaBoost's regression algorithm. AdaBoost is a boosting algorithm proposed in this paper by Yoav, Freund of AT&T Bell Labs in 1995. Using AdaBoost improves accuracy. This is an ensemble learning method that trains multiple models from sampled data and aggregates the results. In this video, we mainly refer to this document written in 1999 by Yoav Freund, the author of the paper on the left. In general, boosting is an algorithm that gradually strengthens weak learner models. And the prediction step synthesizes the results of multiple trained weak learner models. AdaBoost is an algorithm that learns from increasingly more misclassified data points. Let's take a look at AdaBoost's boosting algorithm. Let's take a look at the training and prediction stage separately. The training data we will use is as follows. The number of data points is M, and the number of features is P. It performs row subsampling, but unlike random forest, it does not perform column subsampling. And the target class Y is +1 or -1. AdaBoost's default algorithm for binary classification defines Y as -1 or +1. Y is not 0 and 1. We will look at this case later with the modified algorithm. Perform row subsampling in the first iteration. Initially, set the sampling weights D to 1 over M. This means a uniform distribution. Row subsampling is performed with replacement. And create a subset. Next, we create a model to train this subset. This model is a weak learner. Decision trees, support vector machines, etc. can be used for weak learner models. If you use decision trees, set the depth to 1 or 2 to create a weak learner. A weak learner is a model that performs slightly better than a random prediction. For example, for decision trees, make max depth as shallow as 1 or 2. And for support vector machines, adjust the C and gamma value to ensure that the decision boundary is not too detailed. We now use this subset to train the model. H1 is the model created and trained in the first iteration round. Then use the trained H1 model to predict the class of the entire training data. When training data is input to the H1 model, the predicted class Y hat is output. We then use the predicted Y hat to calculate the misclassification error rate. I is the indicator function, and D is the sampling weight. For example, let's calculate the misclassification error rate. Let's say the number of data points M is 3, the actual target class Y is like this. And the predicted class Y hat is like this. The first and second Y hats match the actual class's Y well, but the third Y hat does not. Let's look at the indicator function I. If this condition is true, then the indicator function I is 1. And if this condition is false, then the indicator function is 0. So in this case, the indicator function I is 0. Here it is 0, here it is 1. Since these two data points match each other, the condition is false and I is 0. And since these two data points do not match each other, the condition is true and I is 1. And the initial sampling weights D are uniformly distributed, so they are each 1/3. Now let's multiply the sampling weights D by the indicator function I. Then the result of DI looks like this. The sum of all DI values is the misclassification error rate, epsilon, of 1/3. Since one case out of three is misclassified, the misclassification error rate of 1/3 is correct. And the accuracy becomes 2/3. Next, we calculate the alpha value in the first iteration round. The formula for calculating alpha is as follows. We will see later how to derive this formula, but for now, let's just use it. Alpha is assumed to be a positive value. For this to happen, epsilon must be less than 0.5. Random predictions result in an epsilon of approximately 0.5. Weak learners perform slightly better than random predictions. So their epsilon will be less than 0.5. Next, we use this alpha value to calculate the sampling weights D2 that will be used in the next iteration round. If y is equal to y hat, then y times y hat is plus 1. If both are plus 1, it is plus 1. And if both are minus 1, then it's also plus 1. Therefore, for well-classified data points, this sign will be negative. This is because alpha is assumed to be positive. This reduces sampling weights D2. Conversely, if y and y hat are different, multiplying the two results in minus 1. Then this sign becomes positive, and the sampling weights D2 increases. Now let's look at what this means. Make the sampling weights D of well-classified data points small, so that only a few are sampled in the next iteration round. On the other hand, make the sampling weights D of misclassified data points large so that more data points are sampled in the next iteration round. This means that more misclassified data points will be trained. Now in the second round, row subsampling is performed using the updated sampling weights. This is not a uniform distribution. In this way, a new subset is created and another model is created and trained. Let's call the model for the second iteration round H2. We then use this model to predict class Y again over the entire training data. Calculate Y hat, epsilon, and alpha using the same process as above. And then recalculate the sampling weights to be used in the next round. Repeat this process in this way. Bagging is a parallel structure, while boosting is a serial structure like this. The more this process is repeated, the more misclassified data points are sampled, resulting in more training. This is the core idea of AdaBoost. So that's the training process. This time, let's look at the prediction process. We feed the test data to multiple weak learner models trained on subsets. We then multiply the output of each model by its respective alpha. The alpha calculated in each round is used as the model's weight in the prediction step. And we add up all of these results together. If this result is negative, the final class is predicted to be minus 1. And if it is positive, the final class is predicted to be plus 1. Now let's take a look at the role of alpha. If the misclassification error rate of the first model, epsilon 1, is large, alpha and epsilon are inversely proportional, so alpha 1 is small. That is, the result of a model with a large error is multiplied by a small alpha. And the result of a model with a small error is multiplied by a large alpha. Because the model with a small error is highly reliable, it is multiplied by a large alpha. Conversely, the model with a large error is unreliable, so it is multiplied by small alpha. This is the basic algorithm of AdaBoost. This time, we will look at the formal algorithm for AdaBoost binary classification. Again, classes Y are minus 1 and plus 1. This algorithm was introduced in a 1999 paper by Yoav Freund. X is the feature data and Y is the target class. Initializes the sampling weights D to 1m of. Initially, data points are sampled from a uniform distribution and repeat T times. Perform sampling of the training data and generate a subset according to the sampling weights D. And use this subset to train the weak learner model HT. Then input training data into model HT to predict the target class. The prediction result is HX, which is Y hat on the previous page. Measure the misclassification rate by calculating the probability that the actual Y value is different from the predicted Y value. It is identical to this expression on the previous page. D is the sampling weight, which is a probability distribution. So this is the probability epsilon. And then calculate alpha using epsilon. Alpha must be greater than 0. For this to happen, epsilon must be less than 0.5. Use this alpha value to update the sampling weights D to be used in the next iteration round. If the predicted value and actual value are the same, it will be negative alpha. And if they are different, it will be positive alpha. So you can write it like this, where Z is the normalized constant value. It is the same as what you saw on the previous page. That's the training stage. The prediction step aggregates the results from multiple models. What we saw on the previous page can be expressed in this standardized algorithm. This time, let's derive the formulas for alpha and epsilon. I referred to this article written by Raul Rojas in 2009. The final output formula of the Yoav Freund model seen on the previous page is as follows. The symbol notation is slightly different on this page. M is the number of iterations and N is the number of data points. And we denote the model with K instead of H. Let's write this part of this equation as follows. The output for up to M minus 1 iteration round can be expressed like this. alpha is the weight to be applied to the model we looked at on the previous page, and K is the weak learner. And the final output for up to M iteration round can be written like this. Here the final output is Y hat. Now let's define the exponential loss function like this. Sonar plus 1. If Y and Y hat are equal, this value is positive. Since this value is positive, the exponential loss decreases. If Y and Y hat are different, this value will be negative. Since this value is negative, the exponential loss increases. Therefore, if the classification is incorrect, the exponential loss increases. Here we replace Y hat with the following expression. And we define the Y times CM minus 1 part as W. Then write this part as W. And write this part as is. We then separate this equation into well-classified and misclassified cases as follows. For well-classified cases, this value is positive, so we can write it like this. For misclassified cases, this value is negative, so we can write it like this. The first term is the weighted cost of all hits, and the second term is the weighted cost of all misses. The sum of these two terms is the exponential loss. Our goal is to find the alpha that minimizes this exponential loss. Differentiate the exponential loss function with alpha m to find its minimum value. Differentiating this equation gives us, if alpha m is obtained from this equation, it is as follows. Let's break down the exponential loss function on the left and write it down. Let's assume that these are well-classified cases. And these are misclassified cases. Then WC is the sum of these values. And WE is the sum of these values. Here, I think the subscript C stands for correct and E stands for error. And we will write the sum of the total sampling weights as W. Since WC is like this, alpha becomes like this. And the misclassification error rate, epsilon, can be written like this. So we can write this equation as follows. This is the formula for calculating the alpha used in the algorithm on the previous page. Alpha and epsilon are inversely proportional to each other. And the sum of the sampling weights is 1. Since WE is the sum of the weights of the misclassified cases, we can use the indicator function to write it as follows. This is the formula for calculating the epsilon used in the algorithm on the previous page. So far, we have looked at an overview of AdaBoost and the basic algorithm for binary classification. And we have derived the formulas for alpha and epsilon. In the next video, we will use this algorithm to implement the AdaBoost for binary classification.